welcome back for another video. My name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make videos for non-techies. Now, this is going to be a longer than normal video, and we're going to talk SSL, and that is adding a security certificate to your website. We're going to talk about what's the difference between some of the paid certificates and the free certificates and what web hosts will accept. I'm going to try to explain everything in this video as concisely as possible. Now, let me first tell you, an SSL certificate has nothing to do with website security of someone hacking into your website. It has nothing to do that. And the reason I'm bringing this up, because I did make an SSL video before. Some guy was all criticizing me that I didn't have an SSL certificate on my website and I'm not practicing what I'm preaching and stuff like that. But SSL certificates are for securing and encrypting information that goes from your website to someone's computer. That's what it's doing. It's not preventing someone from hacking into your website. Now, typically, if you're going to take any kind of credit card payments on your website, now I'm not talking about PayPal. When someone goes to your website, clicks a button, and then it takes them over to PayPal, that does not require an SSL certificate because all the payment information goes back and forth on PayPal's website, not your website. But if you want to use the PayPal where you're actually taking the payment on your website, or if you want to use Stripe, which is one of the most popular online payment integrations for pretty much any e-commerce platform, then you need an SSL certificate on your website so that information that goes back and forth will be fully encrypted. Now, there's different types of security certificates. There's some free ones, and there's some that cost reasonable amounts of money, like $10 or $20 or $50. And then there's some that are in the hundreds of dollars. And I just kind of want to explain in layman's terms, what's the difference between all of these? So for instance, let me just show you, the easiest way is to show you. Oh, and let me go back. If you see on my website, I did add an SSL certificate to my website. Let me step it back a minute. The reason why you really want to give some serious consideration to adding an SSL certificate to your website is because, number one, it's an SEO factor for Google. So basically, if you had the same content on a non-SSL site and a website that did have a certificate, Google's going to favor the one that has the security certificate. Google wants everything encrypted. So much so, in the year 2017, on the Google Chrome web browser, they are going to have notices when people go to a website and it's not running behind an SSL certificate. So this right here is an image of what that warning's going to look like. So right now you can see right here, if someone was on your website and trying to log in, it would look normal. That's how it looked today. But come 2017, this big warning sign that says not secure is going to show. And that might freak some people out. And people, the average user is not even going to know what the heck that means. They're going to think that the whole website is not secure. So that would appear kind of right here, this not secure message. So that is another important reason why you have a lot of web people saying right now you really want to get onto an SSL certificate and start encrypting the traffic on your website. So that is that. So those are the two reasons why you really got to give some strong consideration to implementing it. Now, there are some different categories of paid certificates. So when you're looking at a Google search, I just did a quick search for buy SSL certificate, and I want to show you the difference between what a $6 certificate costs or looks like in a web browser and what a more expensive in the hundreds of dollars a certificate's going to look like. And so let me just click on this first ad here. Kind of stinks they're going to pay for that click. This is a normal certificate. You've got the padlock in the top left, and it says in green HTTPS. That's your typical basic security certificate. Let me show you the difference between the ones that cost a lot more. When I click on this link, you see right here, it doesn't just have the padlock. It says in green the name of the company That is called an EV certificate, which stands for Extended Validation Certificate. And those are the ones that cost in the hundreds of dollars. So for instance, this website right here sells that EV certificate for $300. So it's going to cost a lot more. So $6 or even free, and I'm going to talk about that, will give you, get you this padlock, and that's what I have. But if you want to spend more money, now, if you're a big e-commerce website or if you have anything to do in the banking financial industry, you really want to pay the money and get the EV certificate to have it say your name there. You really, that's a must. That's a definite must. But if you're just the average web user and you've got a website and you don't want people to get that warning when they're using Google Chrome and visiting your website, then a basic certificate is going to be fine. So let me show you some of the options to get a free certificate. There's a new project that started, I think it might have been in 2015, called Let's Encrypt, and they are a free certificate issuing entity. So you can essentially get a security certificate for free. Now, there are a lot of web hosts that support Let's Encrypt, and there's a lot of web hosts that don't, and I don't know why web hosts that there's a lot of web hosts that won't support it, but I do know they had some security problems with these certificates in 2016. I think it was early 2016 and it was in all the news. And so I wonder if the web hosts are taking a wait and see approach with them and that's why they don't. So all your big name web hosts do not support Let's Encrypt security certificates, including the web host that I use and I recommend, which is InMotion Hosting. They don't support it at all. Now, there's an alternative if you want a free security certificate on your website, and I use this extensively, and it's through a company called Cloudflare. They make it super easy. I run all my websites through Cloudflare. They give you a content delivery network. It's a free service, by the way, a free security certificate, and they have some denial of service protection. If someone's attacking your website, they protect you from that as well. And you get all this for free. So in this video, I just kind of want to show you how to get a free certificate with Cloudflare running on your website. And one of the reasons I wanted to make this video was for people that I've suggested go to InMotion Hosting and then they want a free security certificate. That's why I wanted to make this video. Now, if you just wanted to pay for a security certificate and you were fine with that, by far the easiest way is just to log into your web host and order it. Some, it might be $50 or $100, and they do everything for you, and some of them require what's called the static IP address, all this techie stuff, but they'll handle it all for you. You just pay the price, and that's an annual fee. If you wanted to do something like that, that's by far the easiest. I know with InMotion Hosting, they have a button right there. You just click on it, you pay for it, and you'll have your certificate in 24 hours. So if you want to do it that way, that's totally fine. Or you can go the Cloudflare route. Now, with Cloudflare, what you're going to do, you're going to sign up for a free account, and then you're going to, let's just take a look at it together. So you come here, you're going to click on, oops, I didn't actually want to see this video. You want to just go ahead and click right here on sign up, and it's going to take you to this page to get a free Cloudflare account. Just pop in your email and choose a password, agree, you'll get an email, you click on it, and it just verifies your email address. And then you can log in for the first time. And what you want to do is you want to click on this plus add site right here in the menu on the top right. And then right here, you're just going to put in your website URL. So if I go to showthedemo.com, which is one of my websites, and then click on begin scan, then what it's going to do is it's going to do some scanning of something called your DNS records. I know it's a little technical. So it's going to get those records, and then it's going to request for you to make a change where your domain names are registered. So if you have your domain name registered at InMotion or Namecheap, I use Namecheap, you will have to make a little change to what's called your DNS records. You're going to make a change to your name server, not your DNS records. So it's doing its little scan, and it should just take a moment. and it's going to give us some more options that we'll look at together. I've been using Cloudflare for probably the last 2 years. It's a pretty amazing service what they do, and it'll also, through using its service, will speed up your website. So when people are visiting your website, the experience will be more fluid and more fast. Okay, so it's done doing its scan. You would go ahead and click on Continue Setup. Now, right here, it's showing you some technical things. It's just verifying and confirming your DNS records. Now, this is a little bit too technical for most people, and that's okay. You can just scroll down to the bottom and then click on Continue. It's going to be right, these DNS records. Okay, so right here, you're going to choose a plan, and you're just going to go ahead and choose the free website plan like that. And you can see right here, it's the free SSL. Go ahead and click on Continue. And this is where you need to change your name servers. So right here, it shows me my current name servers, which are with InMotion Hosting, but I need to change it to these. Now, if you don't know how to do this, you can easily Google it and come up with an answer. So you would Google the name of where your domain names are registered and then type in the word change name server, and you will have instructions for it. So if it's Namecheap that you're with, you can even contact their support and they'll tell you what to click on and how to do it. It's usually pretty easy in these control panels. When you log in and you look at your domain name, there'll be something there that says set or change your name servers. And that is something that you're going to have to do in order to get it to work. You needed to change it to these two name servers that it gives you to change it. And what this accomplishes is now when someone visits your website, they're first going to flow through Cloudflare. And what Cloudflare is going to do is some of the content it's going to serve up off of their servers, which makes your website load a bit quicker. And it's also going to allow them to put that security certificate in. So you're going to want to go ahead and do that. And when you make this change, it might take a few hours to go into effect, and you'll come here and be able to verify it. So I'm just going to go ahead and click on Continue and see how it says status pending. It's going to say status pending until it verifies that this change is done and this change goes into effect. And by default, you can see right here, it's going to add a security certificate. But I'm going to go ahead and click on Full. And what you're going to want to do is change this from Full to Flexible. And Flexible is going to be the most easy way to get this security certificate on your website. You can easily click Help right here to read what the difference is. But just go ahead and choose on Flexible. And you don't have to click Save. That's one of the things I like about Cloudflare. They are, as soon as you change the option, it's going to save that for you. So now it's just a waiting game. You're probably going to have to wait 24 hours for the certificate to be issued, and if you make your change to the name server, for that all to go into effect. And what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to test your website by entering HTTPS and then the website URL and seeing if it gives you what's called a certificate warning. So that's a warning that says there's no valid certificate. Now, if the certificate's been issued, it's not going to give you that warning. Now, all that's going to be left is you're going to have to install a plugin on your WordPress-based website. And what this plugin's going to do is it's going to do everything WordPress needs to make it so whenever someone visits your website, they're going to get the HTTPS, the secure version of your website. So if someone types HTTP and then your website URL, it's going to redirect them to the secure version, HTTPS. And that's what this plugin is going to do. It's just called Really Simple SSL. I have a full video on the plugin. It's really easy. All you have to do is go to Plugins, Add New, search for Really Simple SSL, install and activate, and it pretty much does everything for you. It couldn't be any easier. And I have a video on that. I'll put a link to that video down below. I'll also put some links to Cloudflare for you, and I'll put a link to Let's Encrypt as well. But this is the easiest way to get an SSL certificate on your website. So in January, when Google Chrome's going to start throwing up that warning, you will not have that warning for your website visitors. And you'll also get this SEO boost and this SEO benefit of having a security certificate on your website. So that's all there is to installing a free SSL certificate on your website. Now, I know this might be a little more technical or a little more complicated than some of my other videos. If you need help in this process, feel free to leave a comment down below and I'll gladly respond to you and help you in any way if I might have left a little piece here out or there. If you're running into any trouble, I totally want to help you get an SSL certificate on your website. Hey, before you go, I have something for you. And before I get into that, I wanted to ask you to do something for me. If you could give me a thumbs up on this video. And if you're not a subscriber, click on the subscribe button right beneath me. If you have a question on this video, I'd be happy to answer it. You can also leave a comment or a question down below this video. Hey, I put together a course just for you and I'm gonna give it to you for free. All you have to do is click on the button right here on the right. It's called the 3 Steps to WordPress Success. It's an awesome course. You're gonna love it. I would love for you to join in and enroll as a student in this course. Thanks for watching this video. I really appreciate it, and I do it just for you.